I currently have more than 70,000 subscribers to my YouTube channel, and I have over 10,000 people on a very active newsletter. And about 3 months ago, I did a survey to find out what are the most useful educational technologies, which ones the teachers really use the most. Now, this isn't scientific because it's only on my website and my followers. I'm going to show you the best three tools, the most important, the most useful tools. I'm going to show you ways that these teachers are using these tools, and also going to give you links to videos if you want to learn to use these tools yourself. Each of these tools, and this is good news, has got a free version as well. Let's get straight into the video. Three of the most useful educational technologies. Hope you like the video. If you do, please like it, please share it. Love for you to comment on it and tell me which technology you like the best. And of course, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So Wordwall came in at number three. This website allows you to make a whole range of different activities for checking understanding. There are 36 different game types. This is great anytime you're in a lecture or you're doing a lesson or even for homework and you just simply want to check, did the students understand the video, the lecture, the article they read, the discussion they had, etc. If we was to click on create an activity, you'll see just how many activity types. What I like particularly about this website is A, the number of activity types. It's probably the widest range of activities I've ever seen in one website. But B, how quick and easy it is to make a game and then to share it. Let's just have a quick look at a few of my activities. So if I click here, you can see the activities. I'm only going to show you a couple. I will put on the screen now a video that takes you through this technology in much more detail. But let's just have a quick look at a couple of examples. This is a really simple one where students simply have to match the capital city to the country. So let's quickly play this game. And all you see is that basically it's going to come along on the screen, Paris, and then you have to click on the correct country. There are loads and loads of different games that you can play. You don't have to do it for a really low level. It can be for a much higher level group of students. If I just come down to edit content, look how easy it was for me to make that game. I just wrote the country, wrote the clue. I could have written a sentence. I could have even used pictures. And then I click on the button and the game is ready. And this is what I like, because it makes the games from just simply adding in a text. Now, the other really interesting thing is look how you set the activity for the students to do. Click on set assignment. I normally ask them for their name, but you can be anonymous. And then click on start. And you simply share that link with the students and they can access and play the game. So this is great if you're working in Zoom, because you could be in a Zoom session, doing a session, or in perhaps Microsoft Teams, share the link, students jump off, do the activity, then come back. The other great thing is it gives you a complete breakdown of the results. So if we click here, and let's just take a recent activity I did, this one here with 45 students, and it tells me exactly all the results, which ones they got wrong, which ones I need to perhaps go over again, which ones I don't need to go over because most students got them right, etc. Absolutely love this technology. Now, there are a lot of advanced features in Wordwall, and I'm going to put on the screen now a really popular video where I take you through some of the advanced features, because one of the things you can do is use games that other teachers have created, as well as with one button click change the game and completely change the format of the game. Now, Wordwall does have a free offer. If we quickly click back to all the games that you can play, you can sign up and use it for free, and you can use up to 5 games for free. And the other good thing about that is that you can come in and edit the free games and use them again in a different class. So if you've made a game, you can actually keep changing the content of that game and use it with different classes. Wordwall is not actually a particularly expensive technology, and you might want to look into even buying it, but I would recommend definitely at the beginning, try the free tool and see how you get on. This is without a doubt my favorite technology. The good news about this as well is that the free option is absolutely brilliant. In fact, I only use the free option. I use this technology all the time, the ability to record the screen of your computer. Now, if I show you this and then just show you some of the things that you can do with it, you'll realize why it's so popular amongst teachers. Now, it might be interesting to know that I'm actually using ScreenCast technology, the same technology, to record this video that I'm doing for you. So I'm recording the screen of my own computer. If we click here, and then we click on the next button, which will allow us to open the recorder. And then all we need to do is click on Launch Recorder. Now, the first time you do it, you have got to run this little app. It just takes a couple of seconds just to run a little app that then allows your computer to be recorded, the screen of your computer to be recorded. Okay, great. And so now you can see that the recorder is opened on the screen. I can resize it. And what actually happens is you've got this kind of little app now that you can just use to record anything. Now, what I can do, notice that the apps down here, is that now I can just click on the browser and delete the or minimize the browser. And what we're going to do is we're going to just record myself talking over a PowerPoint slide. So what I can do is you can see is that I can now move the screen to get to the right size that I want to record. And then I can click on this button here. Make sure, of course, that you have got the correct technology connected. You can click here and just make sure that your microphone is connected. I can even use my webcam. I'm not going to do that now. And as soon as I click on this button here, this area of the screen is going to be recorded. Now, this could be a PowerPoint slide. This could be a table. This could be a picture. This could be a student's work. You could be giving them feedback on their work. All sorts of things can be used. And on the screen now, I'm providing you a video that gives you information about lots of different ways that this technology can be used. As I've said, I use this technology all the time. Let's just watch it in action. Click on this button here. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Today we're going to talk about Kultura. I'm going to stop there. I'm going to move to the next slide. And now I can carry on. All right, let's move to this next slide. Blah, 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 blah. So can carry on talking now. Blah, 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 blah. Do one more. Move again to another slide. Again, click on the record button. Counts me in. Blah, 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 blah. Let's say I've finished. Click on done and click on save. And the great thing is that that video is instantly ready. Let's play that video back and see if it worked. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Today we're going to talk about Kultura. Can carry on talking now, blah, 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 blah. Do one more, blah, 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 blah. So this is really powerful because I can record myself recording over anything. And now the great thing is I could upload that onto my Google Drive. I could put it on my YouTube channel. You can connect your ScreenCast technology to your YouTube channel. If you have a Gmail account, you have a YouTube channel, you can simply add up your videos onto your YouTube channel. So this is what a lot of YouTubers use, this type of technology. It's exactly what I use to make my videos. You can, of course, save the video on your computer. I'm putting on the screen now a video that will take you through exactly how to use ScreenCast technology. It is my personal favorite. Just a super quick break from the video. If you do like what you're seeing, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more videos. Look in the top 10 videos and you'll see the most popular videos as well as all these other sections at the top. There's plenty of material on the front page. The other thing that you can do that's interesting is that you can sign up to my newsletter. You get updated with all the latest videos, the blog posts, the online courses, and the free webinars that are often sponsored by companies that I work with. The blogs at the bottom of the page if you want to look at that. And the other thing, of course, is that you can find out about the courses that I run. Thank you very much. Let's get back to the video. So So this was the tool that was given the most votes this year. It's Padlet. It's a wonderful tool. It works like an electronic corkboard. You set the Padlet up, you share the link, the students click on the link, and they can add up their ideas. So it's great for sharing ideas. But what's really powerful is that the way those ideas can be shared can be really varied. Students can add up text, students can add up video, students can add up audio, students can share links, students can add pictures, students can do drawings. And there are lots of different formats. There's not just one type of Padlet. Let me just show you a quick example. Here I've got a group of students, they started the course. I asked them all to record themselves speaking and add it onto the Padlet. And then of course I got them to listen to each other's and to ask each other questions. So you can see how easy. I just shared the link, the students click on the button and simply added themselves onto the Padlet speaking. So great for language learning if you want to do an audio activity. Or what about this example where students simply had to introduce themselves to the rest of the class and talk about what they find hardest about using technology in their teaching? And they all shared their ideas, and then other students had to come read what they said and comment on them. Let me quickly take you through the process of making a Padlet. So all you need to do is obviously create an account. You can create an account for free. Click on Make a Padlet. And let's choose a really simple format, but you'll notice that you've got some great formats here, like using a map or using a timeline. The map one's great because students can click on the map and show where they were born or perhaps where they've been on holiday, and they could add a recording. Timeline's really good for things like history or what they do in a typical day or what they did on holiday on a particular holiday. Doing research around a biography. I'm just going to do a simple one. I'm just going to do wall. And all I need to do is write here what I want the students to talk about. So I've just written in here, tell me three things about yourself. I click on next, I click on start posting. It's as simple as that. Now all I need to do now is share this link with the students. I could share it in Zoom or in perhaps Google, in Google Teams if I'm doing a session online, or share it wherever I need to share the link. The students come onto the link, double click on the screen, great for homework, double click on the screen, write their name, I'm going to put my name here, and then in this case I would click here and then click on audio recording, and then simply, and I'll just do a very quick example, click on this button here. My name's Russell, I speak Spanish and French and English, and now I'm learning Polish. That's the first thing about me. Second thing about me is I'm a big fan of football. I'm a Chelsea supporter and I still play football. And third thing about me is I like to play the guitar and sing, though I'm not very good. Done my recording. Let's imagine that I'm happy with it. I click on playback and save. I can even play it back if I want to.
Yeah.
My name's Russell. Easy is done. Click on save. And then once it's all ready, you'll notice it goes like that. Just click on publish. And that is it. And all the students could add up their recordings. Now, I'm going to put on the screen now a link to a really popular video on my website, on my YouTube channel, that takes you through using Padlet so that you really understand how it works, how you can use the free tool, the tricks to make sure that you can use the free tool. There are lots of little things that you can do to manage to use the free tool. And that video is on the screen now. So hope that video was useful. As I said before, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free videos, lots of great stuff on the opening page. Sign up to my newsletter. You get updated with all the latest blogs, the latest webinars, the latest online courses and all the new videos. I often run free webinars as well. And you can of course find out about all the courses that I run. The blog post is at the bottom of the page. If you want to contact me, you can do that from here. I do run courses online and courses for companies, etc., and do even individual training. And of course, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm going to put some more videos now on the screen about some of the technologies we've been talking about in today's video.